Hi there, everybody, and welcome to Curtis and Jaclyn Dale Softball Stadium. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell for this one. This is the second semifinal game. The 2 seed, the North Carolina State Wolfpack, will be taking on the Loyola Ramblers. The 3 seed, NC State, is 0-1 on the day. Defeated Loyola last night in a run rule game, 8-0-5. Ramblers, not a shabby squad, though, Sam. Certainly a lot of power in their hitting lineup, and today they're going to look to see if they can hop over Brittany Nimmo, the freshman pitcher, getting her second consecutive start.
Yeah, Brittany Nimmo, we saw her start the game earlier. She didn't come out too hot, gave up a couple runs before she was able to come out in the third inning, replaced by the sophomore Harley Hubbard. But we're going to look for Loyola here just to get on top of NC State fast, because that's what NC State likes to do, is they like to get out, they like to get up fast and quick. So if Loyola can counter that and do that of their own, then they might be able to stay in this game as opposed to an 8-0 loss yesterday.
Nimmo in the circle. Her battery mate is Molly Hutchison, the leadoff hitter for the Ramblers. Erica Nagel, right fielder for Loyola. Loyola in their charcoal gray uniforms with the gold and maroon numericals and trim. NC State in their white uniforms, black bottoms combo, red numericals, black trim.
And if Loyola is going to get on top, then obviously your first batter, Erica Nagel, with the 587 average on the season, 37 hits and 63 at-bats, she's the one to do it. She's the one to get on also with a little bit of speed, but
Lana Van Dyken makes the play, throws over to Burrows at first, and Nagel is retired. Solid play from the senior shortstop on the defensive side of the softball. That's going to bring Brooke Wilson to the plate. She's in center field tonight for the Ramblers. What's at stake for both of these teams? For NC State, it'll be a rematch with Northern Illinois if they win. That'll be at 12:30 tomorrow. The morning cap game will be the loser of this one, taking on the Delaware State Hornets. The Hornets hung with NIU all game long, and it was the Huskies who came away with a walk-off RBI single to advance the championship game of the Doubletree RDU Challenge.
Yeah, I don't think Delaware State's record in this tournament is going to do them much justice to the talent they have on their team with two incredibly close losses in their last two games. They did get run rule 12-0 by State in the first game, but they've since come back.
Already a couple of balls have gotten around Molly Hutchison. Brittany Nimmo didn't have the best days controlling her pitches earlier in the afternoon during the 12:30 game. Trying to find it here. 1-1 pitch, one out. That slapped right back to Van Dyken, who couldn't make the play. Gets around her, and that's going to be reaching base on the play as Wilson. I was about to say hit, but I'm not sure if it will be scored as a base knock. Scorers are going to give that one as an error to Lana Van Dyken.
Rightfully so.
Well, it just looked like an awkward play there. She took a step forward and then played it hard on the bounce right where the ball was coming down, and that's nowhere to play it. Wodurski, the shortstop, singles out into right field, and the Ramblers have a couple of ducks on the pond for the cleanup hitter. That'll be Bree Pasquale. Solid piece of hitting from Wodurski on the first pitch.
Now batting number 7, Bree
Pasquale is interesting because even as a cleanup hitter, she doesn't have any home runs on the season. Only 6 RBI. She's not really leading the team in, as far as numbers as that goes.
No, but she's sandwiched between Wodurski and Katie Kasubke, who's on deck. Kasubke, the first baseman, 18 RBIs. So this is just going to be a matter for Pasquale of trying to put that ball in play and making sure that she's not grounding into an in-and-ending double play. That one just misses outside. Home plate umpire is Randy McLamb. He was the umpire for State's first game of their doubleheader yesterday. Philip Friels is on first base. Steve Gold down the line at third. 1-1 pitch. Swung on, fouled. Back behind home plate on the third base side.
And with 2 strikes here, I look for Nimmo hopefully to go low. Try to get Pasquale to ground it into something to the left side. Hopefully get it a second up to first for the double play. But
second straight game, NC State's been in trouble with 2 runners on and 1 out. That one right back up the middle. Nimmo with a stab, fires to third. She'll get the lead runner. No play over at first base. 2 outs for Katie Kasubke.
That was probably Nimmo's best chance there. She could have turned around, gone to second, but then it just would have been awkward with runners on first and third. There's no way there would have been a double play there.
Kasupke is the designated player, the freshman batting 357. Two home runs, 18 RBIs, 536 slugging percentage. Good numbers for the long, lanky freshman.
It's quite an impact from a freshman, too. Coming in the lineup make this much of a difference.
1-0 pitch. That one down the pipe, strike one. Kasubke right back in. Runners on first and second with two outs here. Wind up in the delivery. Right back up the middle, off the glove of Nimmo. Kasubke hustling down the first baseline, not in time. Good play by Nimmo to stay with that softball. It was hard hit. She'll flip to Meredith Burrows to end the inning. And NC State's going to grab the bats. They'll head back up to the plate in the bottom of the first. You're watching NC State softball, part of the Doubletree RDU Challenge here from Raleigh, North Carolina. We'll be back with the bottom of the first inning. Welcome back to Curtis and Jacqueline Dale Softball Stadium. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell. Loyola strands a couple of runners on base in the top of the first inning. No runs pushed across on one hit. Lana Van Dyken will lead things off for the Wolfpack. Tyler Ross on deck. Molly Hutchison in the hole. In the pitching circle today will be Kylie Jones for the Loyola Ramblers. She did see some action against NC State yesterday. Her battery mate will be Katie La Savita, who oddly enough will lead things off in the top of the second inning for Loyola. Here comes Lana Van Dyken. First pitch to her is upstairs for ball one. Van Dyken, the shortstop today, batting 227 on the year. Only three RBIs. 6-for-6 stealing, though. Outside ball. Van Dyken, one of those senior leaders, will be sorely missed next year. Finding a shortstop, a new infield captain, always proves difficult. That one's fouled.
Good cut by Van Dyken. I mean, even though her numbers, you know, as far as the offensive end goes, aren't too impressive this year, she does command the field very well, as you said, on defense. And as you said, it's also very hard to find. So she will be missed. Hopefully we'll have someone good to come behind her.
Jones fires and misses up and in. 3-1 hitters count. Kylie Jones coming into the ballgame with a 2.95 ERA. 6-2 record. Very good. 30 strikeouts on the season for her. That one's fouled down the third base line near the state bullpen over and into the mulch area. Full count now to the senior shortstop, Van Dyken. Slaps that one up. Seeing eye single. Van Dyken's aboard. Solid piece of hitting, just letting the bat contact the ball, shortens the swing up and yanks it by the second baseman. Van Dyken is aboard for Tyler Ross.
Now batting number 8.
And Tyler Ross, just as she did in the last game, first inning, she came up with a runner on second base, traded places with a shot to left field, so we'll see what she can do with Van Dyken at first now. Van Dyken did steal first in this exact same situation last game in the first inning, so we'll see if she decides to go on this.
Ross swinging early in the count. Fouls that one into the screen. Tyler Ross now batting 403, 10 home runs, 27 RBIs. Monster season for Tyler Ross. Oh, one pitch. Swing and a miss for strike two.
And it is unfortunate for NC State that 10th home run of the season didn't have anyone on, that it was a solo shot. But, man, if she didn't get a hold of that one.
Did tie the ball game up at that point against NIU. And the Huskies went on their run, 4 unanswered at the end of the ballgame. That pits Mitch's outside.
Good eye there for Ross. 0-2 count you have to be protecting, but you also need to swing it. Stuff that's not too far out of your zone.
1-2 pitch. Ross sits on that one. Could be a bloop single. The second baseman, Alyssa Minucci, is over to make the play for the first out of the inning. Van Dyken slides back to first safely.
It was a good job by Van Dyken there. I mean, she took off for a second and then thought about it a second time. I was like, I should probably turn around and find out where the ball is. So it was a good job by her to get back on that.
Ross flies out at second baseman. This will bring Molly Hutchison to the plate. Hutchison, the third hole batter. She's catching today. Junior batting 353. Three home runs, 15 RBIs. Allen pops the mitt for a ball. Into the windup and the delivery. Outside, Van Dyken gets to second base safely. The throw was offline and short. Lana Van Dyken, 7-for-7 stealing. She's in scoring position.
And you'll see that a lot from softball catchers who elect to throw from their knees as opposed to standing up, just because the bases are so close together, 75 as opposed to 90 feet in baseball. But sometimes it doesn't always work, as we saw there, bounced into second just a little off, so... Good job by Van Dyken there to be ready.
Hutchison sees a strike. She'll dig back in here. Jones eyes the target, gets the signal. Comes center. That one curves off the plate. 3-1.
And I think this will be Hutchison's pitch to hit the at-bat. 3-1, you're trying to throw a strike if you're Jones.
She's been known to drive him. Swings to that one, right back up the middle. Fielded by Wodurski. Throw to first, not in time. Wide turn from Lana Van Dyken. And Brooke Wodurski will be accredited with an error there. Wodurski has not had the greatest of tournaments in the field. That's two errors in as many days. Wodurski committed a similar fielding error. She let one go right between her legs against the Wolfpack yesterday. Really a weekend she's going to want to forget. She was expected to be the best hitter coming into the tournament and just hasn't been. Instead, that order goes to Gazzola from Delaware State. Even though they are going to be playing in the third place game, Gazzola has reached base seemingly every time she's come up to the plate. Meredith Burrows digging in for the Wolfpack here. Burrows, the sophomore first baseman for Sean Reich and company. Solid hitter. See strike one there, evens the count at one apiece. Burrows into the ballgame with a .297 batting average, 7 home runs on the year. And after that ball, it's going to prompt Katie La Savita to head out to the pitcher circle and talk with Kylie Jones. And I'm sure this is just a settle down conversation. Molly Hutchison, not necessarily a threat to steal second base. If she was, Lana Van Dyken is dangerous enough that you could try the double swipe, but it would be dangerous. Alyssa Minucci would be my choice to field this ball. Because right now she's a little more of a hot streak in the infield than her counterpart on the opposite side of the middle infield, Brooke Wodurski. Jones into the windup. Fires this one. This is popped straight up. La Savita has a beat on it. Catches the foul ball back behind the plate for the second out of the inning.
Good hack by Burrows, but just underneath it way too much. And unfortunately, waste of an at-bat.
Now batting number 36, Maggie.
Maggie Hawkins, the third baseman for the Wolfpack. Righty on righty battle here. Hawkins coming in. Senior batting 344. Has enjoyed 6 home runs and 21 RBIs. Slugging at .672.
So no lack of power here by any means. And if you're NC State, you want to get on the board fast because that's what you're used to doing. And getting that early lead certainly helps with your momentum, your composure throughout the rest of the game.
Yeah, but once you get into these games that are bracketed off, everything becomes that much more difficult. Northern Illinois surely thought that they were going to be able to walk all over Delaware State. Would have been mercy ruled by NC State, a team that the Huskies beat earlier in the day, and it ended up going straight into the bottom of the seventh. 2-0 delivery, Hawkins sharply hit foul ball down the first baseline, foul.
That was a two-out walk-off for Northern Illinois. So came down to the wire for sure.
NC State would love to prevent anything from going down to the wire here today. Two on delivery, two outs. Now the third baseline, Van Dyken playing dodgeball. Gets out of the way. 2-2 count, two outs.
Rychick seems to be a target for some of these foul balls going over to the left side.
Hawkins deep in the batter's box. She's going to give herself plenty of time to swing at this one. Lined up in the delivery. That one misses inside. Hutchinson caught in a rundown. Throw back to third. Van Dyken is safe, and Hutchinson will advance to second.
That had to be the most awkward stolen base I've ever seen in my life.
Hutchinson got about halfway to second, stopped on the throw. Van Dyken was kept back on the bag. Good play. Hawkins fouls this one off in the full count situation. Good job by the Ramblers to make sure Van Dyken didn't score, because she was off and going and had to pause for a second as soon as Alyssa Minucci got that ball. And that's why I said, you know, let Minucci take it. She's the stronger fielder, especially in this tournament, and there she does and prevents a run from scoring on an attempted double steal. Hawkins pops this one out to center, and it'll be fielded by Wilson, and that's the end of the inning. NC State strands a couple of runners in scoring position, but ultimately no dice. They plate no runs. We're still tied at zero at the end of the first inning. The Ramblers coming back to bat in the top of the second. You're watching NC State Softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television. Back to Curtis and Jacqueline Dale Softball Stadium on the campus of North Carolina State University in Raleigh. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell. Scoreless first inning. Good ball game so far. Scoreline straight across. No runs, one hit, run error for each team. Sam, it's been closely contested ball game so far, fairly even, but what's it going to take for one of these teams to get an advantage?
Well, as we saw in both the top and the bottom half of the first inning, both teams got runners in scoring position, pretty close to threatening, but neither of them were able to do so. Both teams had an error, and that certainly, you know, can't keep happening. NC State or Loyola, either team, someone needs to produce. Someone needs to convert on these opportunities that they're given. You need to hit with runners in scoring position. You need to move runners up 90 feet. Whether you're playing small ball or hitting the home run, you need to do something that's going to create movement on the base pass.
Brittany Nimmo back into the circle. And that does bring me to a question. What have you thought of the pitching so far? The control hasn't always been there. A couple of fielding errors. Are you looking for the pitchers to start to lock down, or is this the best we're going to see tonight?
I do think it's the best we're going to see tonight, unfortunately. Courtney Barabella came in the last game and, you know, thought she would do pretty well, ended up giving out that two-run home run. So I'm thinking it's the best we're going to see, unfortunately, though NC State does have a lot more potential. I just don't think this is their tournament or their weekend, really.
Katie La Savita, the catcher. Righty-on-righty matchup against the freshman Brittany Nimmo to start the second inning. La Savita turns on one right into the state bullpen. Good job by Courtney Mirabella down there doing some warm-up action to field that ball. Harley Hubbard and Courtney Mirabella up and in the warm-up circles in the state pen. No action going on for the Ramblers. Off speed in there. Two strikes quickly against La Savita. This will be a big strikeout for Brittany Nimmo if she can get it. She gets the signal. Comes center, fires. That's fouled off the end of the baseball bat, or the softball bat, I should say.
And even though a bunch of the pitchers, or any of the pitchers, really haven't been completely locked in for NC State, I am looking for them, you know, to work with it if they can't find their location, to get batters to chase, to get people to swing at pitches they shouldn't be swinging at. Pop-ups, foul balls, grounders, anything that you can get as a pitcher is going to be good for you. Don't give them something easy, though.
Almost certainly not. State normally very solid in the field. Van Dyken committed the error back in the first inning. She's got an excellent fielding percentage. 1-2 foul to the top wire of the screen. Good at bat for La Savita. Gotten a couple of good pieces of pitches. Now trying to come square. She's risen up the batting order in this tournament. Here's the delivery. Called strike three. La Savita retired, staring down the third strike. And that's the first out of the inning. Brittany Nimmo has the first K of the evening.
Huge strikeout for Nimmo, too. She was able to find her spot on that one, which is incredibly good confidence builder for her.
Hannah Jenkins, left fielder. coming to bat here for the Ramblers, a senior batting at even 300. And that one's clubbed down the third base line. Hawkins made the play over to first, but Randy McLam halted play before the throw came across the diamond. Foul ball. Jenkins digging back in, one strike against her. Nimmo into her delivery, fires this one. Good framing by Molly Hutchison, not going to get the call. Count even at one. Jenkins has played and started in 19 games for Loyola, does have one home run, eight RBIs. Slow ball down the middle, strike two. Good pitch from Brittany Nimmo.
And I do think this game will be a little bit better for Nimmo. You know, after getting a little roughed up in the third inning of her last outing earlier today, I do think, you know, she didn't pitch too much. She kind of got her number. The other team had her number. So we'll see if she's able to come out, which she has so far, and pitch a lot better in this matchup.
Outside now 2-2. One out in the inning. Nobody in the base paths. Nimmo comes center, fires, misses low and inside. Count grows full. Nimmo trying not to let the seven-hole hitter wriggle off the hook. Eight-hole hitter on deck is Alyssa Minucci, the second baseman. Here's the delivery. That one sent right back up to Nimmo. Great stab. I think she may have had to move her glove about a half inch over. You talk about hitting it right back to a fielder. Well, that's the definition of it.
Now batting number 17, Alyssa Minucci.
She finished her windup, threw the ball, and it was right back in her glove before she could blink.
Alyssa Minucci, the second baseman, had a couple of nice plays in the first inning. Very solid in the field. However, with the bat, hasn't had as much luck. Still batting 269. Nine RBIs, a couple of home runs. That pitch outside to Minucci.
Seven hits on the season for Minucci. Three of those are doubles, two are home runs. So she only has two singles. More extra base hits than she does singles.
Nimmo picks up the signal. Comes center to fire. Minucci rips that one over toward the state bullpen down the third baseline. Foul. For Loyola, right now, Nimmo's not fooling anybody. They're getting good contacts, even on the fouled-off pitches. That one misses high and away.
It seems like it might be getting to Nimmo a little bit, because when she's missing, she's not missing by a little bit. She's missing by more than she'd like to be.
Well, that's just part of being a freshman pitcher, is you do have to work out your style, and you do have to be able to consistently hit your spots, and I think that's one of the reasons Sean Rychick opted to go back to her today. Grounded over for Van Dyken, fields it cleanly. Sidearms it to first, safe! Meredith Burrows was pulled off the bag, and the Ramblers have a base runner on.
Great effort both by Van Dyken and Burrows. Will be ruled a base hit for Loyola.
Number 28, Jamie O'Brien.
Good hustle from Alyssa Minucci to get down the line. Second hit of the day for the Ramblers in a little two-out rally. Jamie O'Brien, third baseman. She's the nine-hole hitter coming in, batting 138. Bounces this one over to Alyssa Compton. She'll flip over to Van Dyken to get the force out at second, and that'll end the inning. Four batters faced, and it'll bring it back to the top of the order for the Ramblers when it comes back to the top of the third inning. NC State going to grab the lumber. They'll try to take the lead in the bottom half of the second frame. You're watching NC State Softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television. Welcome back to Curtis and Jacqueline Dale Softball Stadium in Raleigh. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell. Hannah Summer leading things off here for the Wolfpack. Loyola had nothing doing in the four batters. They plated up in the top of the second inning. The bottom of the second for NC State will be Summer, Moore, and Compton. Hannah Summer digging in here, junior batting 296, three home runs. Most recent one was yesterday out in the left center. That one comes high and tight inside. Summers the designated player for Sean Reichick today. And this time he won't have to do anything crafty with the lineup. Summer grounds one over to Wodurski, picks it up cleanly, fires to first. Good pick out of the dirt by Pasquale for the first out of the inning.
It was a good play by Pasquale there to make up for her error in the first inning.
Jessica Moore, the freshman, will come up to the plate here. Moore starting in her fourth game has appeared in quite a solid hand few as a pinch hitter. Grabbing the bat, certainly not a poor hitter. Is batting 200, a deceptive average, but has been used as Sean Reichick's go-to pinch hitter in some situations, most notably when he's had to jostle around the infield and get crafty with his lineup card with Alyssa Compton having been out. Compton does make the start at second today for this game. Kylie Jones right back on the rubber. Rocks and fires inside. Moore has a reputation to be a battler at the plate. Popped out in her at-bat against NIU earlier in the day. Swings solidly through that one.
That was a good cut, but all air.
Quick with a bat off of her shoulder, that's for certain. Just got to try to square up here. 1-2 pitch from Jones. And that one's bounced right back out to Wodurski. Fields it cleanly. And once again, back-to-back six threes in your scorebook.
It's a good job by Wodurski just to be ready. As a shortstop, the ball tends to come to you, I mean, obviously more than anyone else in the infield.
Sophomore second baseman Alyssa Compton digging in. Compton, lowest in batting average among starters with 182. Her sixth started game. Missed seven out with injury. Making the start here, though. Compton watches that one high. Ball two in a count. On deck, center fielder Macaulay Prickett. Prickett has seen a lot of action. Seems to be very comfortable hitting in that nine-hole spot. Has increased her batting average significantly, now at 333, but we'll talk more about that when she enters the batter's box, be it either this inning or the next. 3-0, called strike in the upper part of the zone. Compton at second base, typically second baseman, not the biggest players on the team, so smaller strike zone here. Offers at that one and fouls it down the first baseline. Full count now against the sophomore second baseman.
It looked like a two-strike swing on her. It looked like she was defending the plate a little bit. Kind of took a hack at something. She might could have let go.
Would have been close. Full count delivery. Compton offers and comes up with air. That's another strikeout. The first of the day for Kylie Jones. NC State down in short order, 1-2-3. They'll head back out into the field as Loyola will grab the bats coming up for the third inning. You're watching NC State softball on Wolfpack Sports Television and GoPack.com. Back to Raleigh, 1-2-3 coming up in the order for the Loyola Ramblers. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell. An NC State score update of note. The baseball team completed a 3-2 victory over the Boston College Eagles today from Doak Field. On the opposite side of NC State's campus, that'll set up a rubber match tomorrow with the Eagles in the ACC opener for the Pack.
Good way to come back. Pack had a 7-0 loss to Boston College on Friday.
Erica Nagel leading things off for the Ramblers. She sees ball one from Brittany Nimmo. Mirabella Ann Hubbard sat down in the pen for now. Nemo still having some control issues. Has sent a couple upstairs on Molly Hutchison, most notably in warm-ups right before we came back on the air. Let one go incredibly late, and that found its way into the chain links back behind of Molly Hutchison. And now it's 3-0 in favor of Erica Nagel.
And Nimmo, she only has her down for 11 walks and 20 innings pitched, but I feel like it would be a lot more. Make that 12.
It's a free pass on four straight balls as Erica Nagel is aboard. This will bring Brooke Wilson to the plate. And on deck is the ever-dangerous Brooke Widerski. Wilson digging in, looking for some sort of signal. Not going to get it initially.
Nagel
from Jeff Telka.
Nagel is 3-for-3 on the season in stolen bases. So
I'm not so sure if this is going to be a stealing situation, though.
Not really, but I wouldn't be surprised if she did.
Maybe on a 2-and-1 count. Line up for the pitch. That one is beat out. Could be a bloop single. Ross diving and makes the play. Tyler Ross, Superman out in left field, diving to make the play.
She does it at the bat. She does it in the field. I mean, where is Tyler Ross not on her game?
That's the type of effort you like to see from Tyler Ross. Unbelievable catch. You might see that one on ESPN later tonight.
Can we tweet that in with like a hashtag or something?
0-1. Widerski digging in here. Wind up and the pitch. Just upstairs. 1-1 even.
Hopefully that puts some life into this NC State squad that kind of just hasn't looked too alive up to this point in the game.
Been very lackadaisical today after coming out sharp in the first game. Widerski has crushed this one all the way out to right field. It's gone! Widerski with a two-run shot, and there's the power you're expecting to see from number 8 on the Loyola roster, and it's the Ramblers who have drawn first blood, 2-0 Loyola.
And number 8 with her 8th home run of the year. So certainly no lack of power from Widerski. And going oppo on that too is a nice hit, a real nice hit.
Opposite side home run, a lot of power into that one. Majestic arc that just clears the wall. 2-0. That'll clear the bases. Bree Pasquale with a clean slate to work with. Pasquale reached on a fielder's choice, then ended up seeing Brooke Wilson thrown out at third base back in the first inning. This one gets under the glove of Maggie Hawkins, and another runner aboard. That one's going to be a tough one for the scorers to assess. It was a sharply hit ball, but went squarely under the glove of Maggie Hawkins. That's a base hit. Bree Pasquale has a single on her resume. And yet another runner out there for the Ramblers, and this is exactly what you wanted if you're Jeff Telka.
Not so if you're Sean Rychick. Rychick's out there talking to his team right now.
Harley Hubbard is back up in the bullpen warming things up. She came into the game earlier against Northern Illinois. Maybe called upon again here. NIU is awaiting in the top-seeded championship game of the Doubletree RDU Challenge.
Now batting number
24. And NC State will end their tournament play by hosting another one next weekend. Ohio, Bryant, and IUPUI will make the trek down to Raleigh. And that will be the RDU Doubletree invite. Don't mix up your sponsor, Sam.
I'll do my best not to. Yours truly will be on play-by-play for that one.
1-0 pitch.
At least for our doubleheader on Friday.
Katie Kasubke. Here's the delivery to her again. That gets around Hutchison's glove. Advancing will be Pasquale. Another runner in scoring position on the wild pitch from Brittany Nimmo. Something's just not clicking for her today. Nimmo back on the stripe, and we're going to see how much resiliency the freshman can have. One out, runner in scoring position. Here's the pitch. Outside, good stop from Hutchison. That was a fastball in the other batter's box.
I'm expecting if Pasquale ends up coming in somehow that Rychek's going to pull Nimmo.
Wouldn't surprise me in the least.
You don't want to get down by too much in this game, especially after losing by four in the last game.
It's going to be a short lease on the pitcher here. That is a frozen rope in the gap. Could be a double. Around comes Pasquale. She will score. It's a field goal for the Loyola Ramblers on the RBI single.
Yep.
And now Sean Rychek is going to make the move to the bullpen. Brittany Nimmo with the early exit for the second game in a row. Harley Hubbard will make the entrance into the ballgame.
And certainly not a surprise here from Rychek.
It's a very tough one to swallow for certain. For Kasubke, that's a beautiful piece of hitting. Straight over Van Dyken's head, middle of the outfield, bouncer to the wall, well fielded by State to get it back in. That could have easily been a double, if not for good outfield to cut off man throw. The catcher, Katie La Civita, will come up to the plate next.
It's just so reminiscent of the last game we saw from this Wolfpack squad. Three runs scored in the third inning, except at this point, NC State had already scored two, but 3-0 currently for Loyola.
Harley Hubbard into the ballgame here. She's in the number 13 uniform. She'll take her warm-up pitches. La Savita will have a meeting here with Jeff Talca.
And if this goes...
Go ahead.
And if this goes how it went last game also, Hubbard, you know, will throw well in the third, throw well in the fourth, get into a bit of trouble in the fifth, and give up, you know, two runs. Hopefully it doesn't happen, but that's how it was. Hubbard seemed to lose a little bit of control after going two innings.
Well, for NC State, how much of this now is getting it back into your offense's hands and seeing if maybe you can win this with the bat?
Yeah, being down by three at this point, you really would like to not worry about your defense so much. You'd like your defense to take care of themselves and really work on putting life back into your offense.
Well, all the momentum is going in the Ramblers' direction, and if I repeat the score to you, 8-0 final in five from yesterday's contest, you're probably not going to believe me, and if I do say the score Raleigh from what today is indicated, you're probably thinking that Loyola won it. Well, that's just simply not the case. Courtney Mirabella started against Loyola last night, pitched a gem, four-hitter. And now Loyola has five hits in the ballgame, all of them against Brittany Nimmo. The runner on first is her responsibility, but Harley Hubbard is going to take over this ballgame now.
And this Loyola squad, I do think, only had three hits in the entire game yesterday.
Four, yes.
Four against NC State. They have five through two and a third today, including three runs.
La Civita digging in here, still in the top of the third. A three-run inning so far for the Ramblers. Opening ball from Hubbard. La Civita struck out looking. The only strikeout for Brittany Nimmo in the ballgame. The windup and the delivery. Check swing, ball two. Good hold up there from La Civita. He's trying to offer there at a high fastball, but Hubbard still throws a ball, looking for a first strike. She'll get it there on the offer from La Civita. Healthy cut, no contact.
It's looking like Harley's going to do the same thing that she tried to do when she came in the last game, just hitting her spot on the outside corner of the plate.
Misses that one low. Hitters count 3-1. Kasubke over there on first base. One out still. Hubbard getting some encouragement from the dugout and the crowd. That one's fouled sharply off of the railing and the screen conjunction. Full count now.
Solid rip there by La Civita, but just a little foul, so full count, we'll see what happens.
She'll square herself around here. Pulls it back, the delivery swung on, fouled into the mesh. Healthy cut. Hubbard looking for that strikeout with that pitch.
Getting a good beat on it there was La Civita.
Catcher coming in, batting 333. The delivery. La Civita pops this one foul down the third baseline, out of play. And this is what you talked about the strength of Loyola being. They didn't get an opportunity to showcase it yesterday, but straight down the lineup, they can hit the ball. And that's exactly what they've done. The two-run homer from Widerski, and you knew she was going to be the one to have the power. And Pasquale comes around to score on the single from Kasubke.
Yeah, and if you're looking at their sheet, six of their nine starters today hit over 300. So certainly nothing to shake your head at. There's not really many points in the lineup where you can stop pitching. You have to be on your game throughout the whole lineup.
That last foul ball had windshield labeled all over it. Another full count pitch. Wind up, delivery. That one's upstairs. La Civita down to first base. Two on, one out. And when it rains, it pours. Hannah Jenkins lined out to the pitcher earlier in the ball game on a well-hit line drive. Unfortunately for her, it was right at Brittany Nimmo, who made a nice play with a glove. Polar opposites for NC State between today's set of ball games and yesterday's set of ball games, and they're going to try to right the ship as soon as they're able to get back on offense. Jenkins sees strike one. She's in left field today. Upstairs, ball one, count even. Aces apiece.
Harley Hubbard is a good pitcher when she's hitting her spots, too. It's just she's going to throw it by you. She's not going to try to change it up much with a curveball or a slow pitch or a drop. She's just going to throw it right by you, just as she tried to do there.
Courtney Mirabella is already up and throwing some tosses in the state pen. The thing with Harley Hubbard is she's proven to be very streaky. When she's on, she's on. When she's not, she's not. It's going to be at either extreme of the spectrum. 2-1 delivery. That one upstairs. Good catch from Molly Hutchison back behind the plate. And Hubbard is within one hurl of walking the bases loaded.
And it's looking to me right now as if she's not on.
She'll get another signal. Rares back and fires.
Better.
It's a good swing from Jenkins. She was really looking to belt that one out towards center, but comes up with nothing. And it's another full count for Harley Hubbard, back-to-back for her first two batters. Here's the delivery. That one upstairs. Bases chalked full. Pair of walks for Harley Hubbard. Sean Rychick can only stand up and look on here. Lana Van Dyken doing the very senior thing and coming out and having a discussion with her sophomore pitcher. And here comes Alyssa Minucci. Minucci hasn't been the catalyst hitter or the most noticeable player at the plate, but deceptively good back in the order. That's going to get by Hutchison. Run's going to come home and score. And now no force out. Save at first base as it would be normally. Two runners in scoring position, and it's a four spot up on the board here in the third inning.
Sean Rychick's going to go ahead and bring Courtney Mirabella in, it looks like.
It's exactly what he's going to do. He didn't like that pitch from Harley Hubbard, so he has seen enough. Mirabella going to come into the ball game here in the third inning. She'll be the third pitcher of the inning. And she is going to inherit a 1-0 count with one out and a pair of runners on base. We'll step aside here in Raleigh. We'll be right back as Courtney Mirabella will take over the mound. You're watching NC State Softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television. Mirabella enters the pitching circle here in Raleigh. She's the third pitcher, the top third inning. A frame which has so far belonged to the Loyola Ramblers. They have four runs on the board, leading NC State 4-0. Katie Grimes out, and she'll hand off a new pitching sheet, which Molly Hutchison will deliver out to the pitcher's circle, now occupied by the junior, Courtney Mirabella.
And just an unfortunate outing for number 13, Harley Hubbard. She did well earlier, as I mentioned, you know, going through the third and fourth innings of the earlier game pretty easily, getting a couple strikeouts, finding her spots, but today, or later on today, just not able to hit. Just really errant with the wild pitch that gave up the fourth run.
Minucci sees the count grow to 1-1 against her. Once Jamie O'Brien comes to the plate, barring some sort of awkward double play, this will be an inning where Loyola's batted around. And that's a rarity to see against NC State. They've done it a couple times. Mirabella picks the signal, fires. That'll be popped up. Van Dyken under it. And that's a big out. You don't allow the runners to move anywhere. You still have the force intact at first base. And you've got the nine-hole hitter coming up. Really, that's the best scenario you could have hoped for, Sam.
That is the best scenario, especially for Harley Hubbard, who is responsible for both those runners on third and second. So Courtney Mirabella able to get out of this inning, hopefully. Harley Hubbard doesn't have any earned runs.
Jamie O'Brien coming back. She grounded out earlier in the ball game. In fact, last inning. That one misses outside. 2-0. Comment Sean Reichick made earlier was old to have strikes, and they haven't always been there for NC State so far. Mirabella winds and fires. There's a solid cut. Strike one.
NC State has not been singing the same old song that they're used to singing today.
They will get a shot. Still early in this ball game in the third inning. Called strike. Count even at twos. A big chance for Mirabella, the most senior of all of the pitchers on the state roster, to prove her stuff. 2-2 delivery. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Solid pitch from Mirabella. She draws a swinging strikeout from Jamie O'Brien. Two runners stranded in scoring position, but the damage has been done. The Loyola Ramblers leading NC State through 2.5 innings. 4-0 is the score here from Raleigh State. Going to grab a bat and head back to offense. You're watching NC State softball and Wolfpack. Back to Raleigh, and even though it's a very clear night, it certainly seems dreary here for Wolfpack fans, at least. Loyola with a four spot up in the top of the third inning. Macaulay Prickett will lead things off in the nine hole for NC State, trying to start a rally. Prickett in the nine hole has had a productive weekend and has really improved her batting average. Swings through that one for strike one. She's a slap hitter. Petaluma, California native. One of quite a few players from all the way out there. State formerly known as the California Republic.
Drew,
quickly down 0-2.
If I can just tell you the secret to NC State coming back and hopefully winning this game, it's going to be scoring runs.
Well, obviously. The question is, how are they going to manufacture it? Slap hit off the shoulder of the third baseman, O'Brien. Macaulay Prickett safe. And that's going to be scored a knock. That ball bounced. The best thing I can tell you is what that hit looked like to me is when you get one of those little 50-cent rubber balls out of a gumball machine and you throw it on the ground and it bounces a super ball. Well, that's exactly what that softball did, and just so much topspin on it, it rolled off the shoulder of O'Brien. Macaulay Prickett reaches safely. That's going to be scored a base hit for the state center fielder. And back up to the top of the lineup with Lana Van Dyken.
That can happen when you're a slap hitter like that. You have a lot of momentum going forward. You're on top of the ball, but your momentum is pushing you forward. So the ball goes out, but has also had a lot of topspin, so it hit and then bounced a lot further forward and a lot more up than third baseman thought it would.
Van Dyken singled earlier in the ball game in the first inning. Reached all the way around to third base. Was not plated, though. Slap hit, O'Brien, nice snag, throw to second, gets the force, and the lead runner. Van Dyken reaches on the fielder's choice. So no change in the status of base runners, but one out in the inning.
One out, one on for the girl you always want to see up the bat, number 8 left fielder Tyler Ross.
Touch them all, Tyler would love nothing more than to put one out in the bleachers here. And a quick meeting on the mound as Loyola is going to figure out what to do with state's home run leader. Molly Hutchison over there having a discussion with her coach as well. And honestly, you know, you don't really have much else of a choice but to try to attack Tyler Ross. Again, if you miss, miss low and away. I'll certainly look to pitcher outside, but when pitches have gone outside and even creep back in, Ross has been able to reach out there and flare him out for doubles down the third baseline. Got good power opposite way and can pull homers as well.
The thing about Ross is she adjusts to the pitch. She doesn't try to pull balls she shouldn't be pulling.
That one on the outside portion of the plate called strike one. Nice pitch from Kylie Jones. She's really sort of been a little bit of an unsung hero because she's taken a backseat to her offense, but she's been very economic in her pitches. Ross swings through that one, strike two quickly.
Through two and a third, she's only given up two hits.
Two hits and a strikeout. O-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three. Tyler Ross down on three straight strikes. Hefty cuts, but Ross makes no contact. Two outs in the inning.
That is the unfortunate poison of someone like Tyler Ross with a lot of power is able to get on base a lot. Is you also tend to strike out a lot when you have that much power. So team leader in strikeouts with 18 this season.
Molly Hutchison, the catcher, back into the batter's box here. That's up and away, ball one. Jones has been dominant in a different fashion. As you mentioned, only two hits given up so far through the ball game. And I believe the quote from Bull Durham is, strikeouts are fascist, ground balls are a whole lot more democratic. Well, it's been a democratic process out in the infield as Jones has really forced state hitters into keeping it low on the ground in the dirt. One defensive error committed by Brooke Widerski. That's it.
She's really trusted her infield. I mean, just shows a lot of character from her and a lot of trust and respect for her teammates.
Widerski's made a couple plays, a couple pop-outs. 1-2 count now to Hutchison. Here's the pitch. That one misses outside. Count even at 2. Van Dyken over on first base, grounded into a fielder's choice and reached as Macaulay Prickett was thrown out on the advancement to second. That one was tipped just barely and dropped back behind home plate by La Civita. Two-two pitch, two outs, runner on first. It's Kylie Jones back on the stripe. Into the motion, fires, and she plunks Molly Hutchison, who throws the bat over to her dugout in disgust. Took it right around the hip area, and she'll walk down to first. That fastball was over 60 miles per hour, and she took it hard. But two runners will be on base now for Meredith Burrows. And Tyler Ross has, no pardon, it's Cheyenne Balzer instead, who will be heading over to first base. Molly Hutchison will come off, and Balzer will take her place. It'll be interesting to see. Balzer might stay in the game as the catcher. We'll see what the call is going to be. That's certainly what I would expect. Meredith Burrows comes into the ball game. Popped out to the catcher, La Civita, earlier in foul territory.
Burrows second on the team in home runs with 7, so no lack of power there. Maybe not expecting her to hit a home run here, but definitely someone who could jerk a ball to the outfield.
They'd love to see her do that here. 3-1 shot would put State right back in this ball game, and She's due. Sees another one over the middle. Burroughs, a little hesitant to swing the bat here, and now down in the count, 0-2. Jones comes center, fires, and gets Burroughs swinging. Superb pitching by Kylie Jones as she adds a pair of Ks to her resume. And Loyola is out of the inning unscathed. 4-0 Ramblers leading the Wolfpack. Loyola coming back to bat. You're watching NC State softball on Wolfpack Sports Television and GoPack.com. Welcome
back to Curtis and Jacqueline Dale Softball Stadium. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell.
NC State not having the best of luck in this ball game. They're down 4-0 to the Loyola Ramblers. Cheyenne Balzer came in as a pinch runner for Molly Hutchison in the bottom of the third inning. She's going to stay back behind the plate. Interesting move by Sean Rychick, taking out one of his better hitters. Erica Nagel leading things off here. She's the top of the order. Ran out for a slap attempt there. Courtney Mirabella blows it by her for strike one. Balls are her new battery mate. Rest of the field stays the same. This is going to be slapped down the third baseline, foul. Quickly 0-2 in Mirabella's favor.
Another secret to NC State winning this ballgame is going to be to get outs on the defensive end.
Obviously, getting the outs are going to be important, but manufacturing those outs is going to be quite a different story, especially when you get into this portion of the batting order. The first four have really been outstanding. And I'd even be willing to extend that out to the first five, including Pasquale, who's reached on a fielder's choice and also singled. Widerski in the three-hole has a single and a home run. Brooke Wilson with a hard-hit ball reached on an error. And Erica Nagel forced a walk back in the third. She's close to doing it here. 2-2. She's going to go right up the middle. She says, I'll take the base and earn it myself with a single there. Loyola continues to hammer the ball. That's their sixth hit of the ball game. A single for Erica Nagel. And now you're seeing why she came into this ball game batting 587. Only one home run. It's not power hitting. It's just accurately putting the bat on the ball and finding the gaps. And Nagel is a master at doing so. This brings up Brooke Wilson, the center fielder. We'll see if she can add to her resume. Has reached first once. Also flew out on a beautiful play by Tyler Ross out in left field. If not, she would have a single. That would make it where almost every player, save the nine-hole hitter, Jamie O'Brien, had reached first. Jamie O'Brien is the only one. I misread my own scorecard. Throw down to second base. In there safely is Erica Nagel. She's in scoring position with a swipe bag. Wilson did reach first on an error back in the second inning. So the only player who has not touched a base today is O'Brien. She'll have to wait a little while before coming back to the plate. Count even to Wilson here. And that's bunted down the third baseline, foul. Nagel now 4-for-4 stealing on the season. Good numbers for her. One-two delivery. Swung on and missed. Critical strikeout for Courtney Mirabella. However, that is going to bring Brooke Widerski to the plate. Widerski hit a two-run home run last inning that started the offensive rally for the Ramblers. She'd love to do it again.
Huge home run for sure, but not the only thing that's kept this Loyola team in the game. I mean, they're hitting the ball, they're getting on base. Just as you said, Erica Nagel, I mean, batting 587 coming into this game. This is a team that might not be the most powerful, might not get a bunch of home runs, which they usually don't, but they're going to get on base and get to you.
Widerski quickly behind the count, 0-2. Certainly that has not deterred power hitters in this tournament. Tyler Ross hit a home run on an 0-2 count. Here's the delivery. Inside, healthy cut on a high chin music pitch. Count will stay even at 0-2. Still only one out in the inning.
got to be careful of those pitches up and in. But that's why you see a lot of the softball players wearing masks, hitting that ball and come up and smack them in the face.
That one's a blooper under it to make the play as Compton, two retired in the inning. She wasn't far off from going opposite way with that one, just hit it off the top part of the barrel of the bat and didn't quite square up. Bree Pasquale reached on a fielder's choice and has a single today. Cleanup hitter batting 318, see strike one there. Always encouraging when your pitcher starting to manufacture some more outs here. There is a runner in scoring position, but Courtney Mirabella not panicking. That one inside off the elbow pad. Free pass down to first base for Bree Pasquale.
It's
Wait a minute.
Ruled a foul ball.
That is going to be ruled a foul ball. Well, you could hear that one up here in the press box, even through the closed windows. I thought it hit her on the elbow pad. Randy McLamb said, nope, that hit the bottom of the bat. And we heard a ball hit the bottom of the bat yesterday. It doesn't quite make that thud dunk sound like it does when you hit an elbow pad, and I think that's what Jeff Talica is saying, and it is going to be a free pass. So now runners on first and second.
Now Rychick's going to come out and talk to him about it.
Yeah, but I don't think you can overturn this one. That's just, you saw it one way, but you heard it another, and I'm more inclined to trust my ears on this call. And when I can hear that thud, you know, having played ice hockey for a while in my younger days, and you do get used to hearing those plastic pads hit up against something, that's exactly what it had to be. Sean Rychick is going to lobby his case here. And if you recall, Sean Rychick has really had an issue arguing hit batsman versus foul ball. This is the third time he's been out to talk to an umpire about this, and now he's going to go out and have a discussion with Philip Friels.
His argument is the ball popped up, and he's making some hand motions right now, but he's saying
I think his argument is the exact same thing he said yesterday against this same Loyola team, is that when you're pulling the bat back, you're opening up the knob, and that's the only place the ball could have contacted. And Sean Rychick clearly frustrated here, but he'll head back to the dugout dejected. And now his team in a little bit more of a pickle. Two on, two out. And Katie Kasubke coming to the plate here. Kasubke, RBI single last time at the plate. Watches that one outside, ball one.
And Mirabella need not waste any time. She does need to throw the ball, just throw strikes. I mean, another key to winning this game is, you know, throwing strikes.
Well, there it is. Count even at one. It's a very nice pitch. Low inner portion of the plate. Difficult to get the hands down, get the barrel of the bat in that area. That one upstairs. Good pick by Balzer. 2-1 with two outs. Runners on first and second. Anything in the grass, and you can imagine the runner from second is going to be spun around. That's Erica Nagel, who got to second base stealing. Very nice steal as well. Really didn't have any chance for Balzer to throw her out. Count's going to grow full here.
Dangerous count for Mirabella. You don't want to get yourself into something where you're giving the other team something easy to hit, but you also don't want to walk the bases loaded.
The delivery. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Huge strikeout for Mirabella, and NC State gets out of the inning. Loyola strands a couple of ducks out on the pond. NC State going to grab the lumber and head back to try to get something going on the offensive side of the softball. You're watching the Doubletree RDU Challenge on Wolfpack Sports Television and GoPack.com.
Come back to Curtis and Jaclyn Dale Softball Stadium. Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell. We're glad that you are joining us here for softball, as certainly it's an intriguing Saturday in sports. A couple of basketball title games going on. Right now, ending the first half, West Virginia leading Kansas in the Big 12 basketball championship game, 34-33. Kansas, number one team in the nation.
Grounder. Good play by Wodurski. Long throw off the bag. Maggie Hawkins on the good hustle has the leadoff single to start off the fourth.
Wodurski going for that Derek Jeter-esque softball shortstop position throw, and I mean that's just really hard to do in softball.
Well, it's good to see Maggie Hawkins down on first base, NC State trying to get something going offensively, but it's kind of frustrating when you were talking about basketball. I didn't get to finish my comment, but we're not going to blame her. Certainly NC State's going to take all the offense they could get. Hannah Summer, goodbye. See you later. Look out of the light pole. Look out Western Boulevard. That is gone. Hannah Summer springs one, and it's still falling here at the end of winter. Unbelievable. Make it 4-2 with one swing of the bat. Hannah Summer catching fire. Well, Sam LaFell, that's the spark you needed.
That was not even a question coming off the bat. I mean, she hit that, and I thought it was already gone as soon as she hit it. I mean, just absolutely destroyed that ball.
Somebody might want to go search Pullen Park to see if they can find a yellow object that has a big black scorch mark on it. She torched it. And Jessica Moore, the freshman, she's going to have a tough act to follow there, but good to see the Wolfpack are on the scoreboard, and this is a softball game again. Wodurski fields, fires, and beats the runner by a step. Alyssa Compton, second baseman, plagued by injury in the early portions of this season, will come out. And now I can't finish my comment about basketball. The ACC title game between North Carolina and Virginia at 9 o'clock.
Wahoo.
So we're certainly glad that you're joining us here, and then you can flip over to your respective favorite station and be able to watch what should be an exciting conclusion to a wonderful day of sports. That one inside, count even at 1. Compton struck out back in the second inning.
Can you choose favorites on Wolfpack Sports Television Network? Can we pull for someone in that game?
As an unbiased sports broadcaster, I cannot accept that. Good throw from second base, Alyssa Minucci. I tell you what, Minucci has been one of my favorite players who's been underrated in this tournament. She's been very solid with the glove out in the field, a sure-handed fielder. Has also had a couple of critical hits for Loyola. This will bring Macaulay Prickett to the plate. Last one's a 4-3 in your scorebook, but mark that one down as a pretty special play from Minucci. Prickett, slap hitter. Reached on a single her last time before being thrown out on a fielder's choice. And that one bounced right over. O'Brien picks it up, fields it cleanly, fires to first. The inning is over. Hey, Sam, I think that home run's still falling. Hannah Summer has given the NC State Wolfpack life with a two-run shot. It's now 4-2 as we head into the fifth inning. Loyola coming to bat. You're watching NC State softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television. Home run has given NC State newfound life coming into the top of the fifth inning here. Katie LaCivita, the catcher, leads things off for Loyola. Team, to their credit, recomposed themselves and was able to retire NC State in short order after the homer. This is a blooper right to the middle of the infield. Alyssa Compton, good range. Nice little shoelace basket catch on the first pitch of the inning. Just your routine F4 with another nice reaching grab from a State fielder.
Pretty good defensive work by State in this game. Play earlier by Ross and there by Compton.
Well, if you erase the third inning, they're up 2-0.
You erase the fourth inning, they're down 4-0.
That's a very fair point. 0-1 now to Hannah Jenkins. Lined out, walked. And quickly now down in this count, 0-2. I never figured you to be the one to give me that retort. That one upstairs. Nah. Free pass. Randy McLam says that one hit her on the paw. Sean Rychick walking away. He's pacing. That was, it's still, that's just sort of plagued Sean Rychick. Right down there, hands, barrel of the bat, bottom knob area. At time, Randy McLam's going to give the free pass to Jenkins. So this will bring up Alyssa Minucci, who had a nice defensive play in the bottom of the fourth. Minucci has a single and also popped out to Lana Van Dyken. And gets away from Cheyenne Balzer and all the way down to second base. Another runner in scoring position here as Jenkins stands on the middle bag. Cheyenne Balzer will get credited with the pass ball there. Count even at one. Solid cut, fouled out of play down the first base line.
Luckily, that was not headed for a windshield.
Well, no, from what I had heard from one of our technical producers, Logan Sims, is that somebody is going to have a crack in their windshield once they get back outside. Going around on the play was Minucci. She strikes out on the check swing. And I know I've said this often, but this is another critical strikeout for Mirabella, because now you have two outs and the runner in scoring position doesn't look quite as threatening.
And once again, this is the time to do it with your nine-hole Jamie O'Brien up the bat.
Well, Mirabella's come in and really controlled the softball game. O'Brien fouls that one down the third baseline out of play. O'Brien, the only Rambler who has not touched first base today.
And Mirabella trying to keep that the same after this at-bat.
That one upstairs, count even at one.
And as you said, though, Mirabella's really controlled the pace of this game. I mean, she hasn't let it get away from her too much. She's been pretty composed throughout it. Definitely a better job than either of the other pitchers she's seen before her.
And that one misses outside. Mirabella coming in a junior pitcher, has another year left. Certainly excited to see what she can do with another year of maturity. She's the ace of the staff right now. That one across the plate. Count even at two. It's a very nice pitch from Mirabella. Now she is going to force Jamie O'Brien into a place where anything close, you're going to have to swing. Wind up in the delivery. Swung on and fouled into the state bullpen. That one pops right back out as it hit one of the poles down there. One of the supports for the meshing that ends up stringing around the end of each dugout to protect the spectators back behind home plate. Line up of the pitch. That one's outside. Full count.
That was a good eye here by O'Brien. Good defensive hack on the last one and good way to watch that one in.
Well, Harley Hubbard got herself into these situations and ultimately walked a couple batters. That one's right back up the middle. Could be an RBI into center field. Play at the plate. The throw on the way. Balzer makes the play, but the throw is late. Coming around to score is Hannah Jenkins from second, and it's 5-2 on the RBI single from Jamie O'Brien. And now every Rambler has at least advanced 75 feet, and that's very tough to do on this Wolfpack team. Against this Wolfpack team, I should say.
As Loyola failed to get anyone, I mean, really past second base at all yesterday, they might have done one or two, but people running around today on the base pass, that's five runs, seven hits.
Erica Nagel, top of the order, singled last inning. Just walked and also grounded out. That one wide, Balzer, throw down the throw, beats the runner, and thrown out with ease. Jamie O'Brien goes down, got an awkward slide in, not a good jump off the pitch. And that is the third out of the inning, but another run does come across for the Ramblers, and NC State will head into the bottom of the fifth, down three, to grab some more lumber and try to chip away at the deficit. You're watching NC State softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television.
Good evening, Wolfpack fans, back at Curtis and Jaclyn Dale Softball Stadium. Going into the bottom of the fifth inning, partner Drew Blevins had to step away from the microphone for a second, but we're down 5-2, the Wolfpack are to the Loyola Ramblers. Leading off for the Wolfpack is going to be top of the order, number 10, Lana Van Dyken.
Van Dyken into this ball game has not been one of the better hitters for NC State, but is functioning well in this leadoff position where she's used to being. This time she bounces one down to first base. Top play, Van Dyken beats the throw. She's safe. What a hustle play from the senior shortstop. State has another leadoff runner aboard. Now you're getting into the murderer's row portion of this batting order. And look out, here comes some power, Tyler Ross.
Number eight, Tyler Ross. NC State would love nothing more here than to get a dinger from Tyler Ross.
Ross, lefty versus righty, and when you have so many right-handed pitchers in softball, this gives her an advantage. That one on the outside portion of the plate for strike one. I see you've also picked up the terminology of our leading technical producer, Ethan Barry. Do have to give a hearty congratulations out to Ethan. This is his first direction of a live broadcast, and so far he's done very well. So kudos to him, constantly growing station at Wolfpack Sports Television, and always nice to see some of the young guns getting some action. Tyler Ross quickly behind the count, 0-2. Here's the delivery. And that one's low. Van Dyken opts to stay pinned on the first base bag. The other member of our crew is Crystal Liu, working the camera. Another rookie, not a freshman, but a rookie to the station. Swing and a miss, strike three for Raw. She's retired. Second time in a row that she's struck out.
Going to be 19 on the season for Tyler Ross.
And Molly Hutchison will re-enter the ball game here to bat. And that is allowed in softball. Hutchison coming back in. This really big position for her. You can turn it over to Meredith Burrows and be confident, but again, in any comeback effort, especially as you tail into the later portions of this ball game, you have to be very, very careful with every out that you take. Here's the delivery. Swung on, right back up the middle, around the diving second baseman, who's Minucci. Wheeling around is Van Dyken. She'll get the hold-up signal at third base. Hutchison will advance, and she will be at second. Two runners in scoring position. The tying run coming to the plate is Meredith Burrows. And now there is going to be a discussion led by moderator Katie La Savita, who's also doubling as a catcher when she's back behind home plate. This is a major at bat right here, NC State trying to get something going.
And that was just heads up base running too by Molly Hutchison. They knew that Loyola was looking for Lana Van Dyken to possibly make that turn and go home. So they were looking more towards third base, home plate. Molly Hutchison just had heads up, was looking at the ball, and took second base with ease.
Well, the Ducks are on the pond here. Only force outs at first base. Meredith Burrows digs in here. First pitch to her is outside. Burrows struck out in the third inning. Popped out in foul territory to the catcher, La Savita, into first. Watches that one low and away. Not quite the capacity crowd we saw in the afternoon cap game, but those who are here starting to make a little bit of noise for the sophomore first baseman. That's a frozen rope!
Wow.
Double play! Unassisted double play for O'Brien, who caught the ball on the bag. And the side is retired. NC State strands two in scoring position. Jamie O'Brien playing the hero. She has an RBI single and now the unassisted double play. Ramblers coming back to bat in the top of the sixth. The score, Loyola 5, NC State 2. Back with the sixth inning after this. You're watching NC State softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television. Welcome back to Curtis and Jacqueline Dale Softball Stadium, a little slice of heaven on the corner of Cates and Morrill. NC State trying to string together a comeback, had a really good opportunity in the back end of the fifth, and they were thwarted when Jamie O'Brien makes a nice stab on a line drive from Burrows and catches it about 12 inches from the base, steps on it, and that's the force out against Lana Van Dyken. Inning over. Courtney Mirabello will go back in the circle here. 1-2-3 in the order will lead off here for the Loyola Ramblers, Nagel, Wilson, Wodurski. Slap hit, sprayed down the line, foul. Well-controlled hit, a lot of side spin on it, just kept slicing and slicing and slicing. Ross had a nice beat on it, but if it had been fair, no telling the bounce that could have made.
Tyler Ross running with a head full of steam. Up until about the last second, she wanted to die for that.
You talk about players who play with reckless abandon. Tyler Ross is one of them. She has one gear, full speed. That one low and away. First ball in the count, 1-1. Nagel had a single in the fourth. Grounder over for Van Dyken. Hard hop, well fielded. Nice throw, and she gets the out. That's why she is the senior starting shortstop. Lana Van Dyken with a superb defensive play.
Nice play by Van Dyken there to watch the trajectory of those bounces and figure out where it was going to be and where's the best place to field it.
Well, and that can't feel good as she took that right off of her catching side shoulder, fields it in the glove. That's why, kids watching at home, that's why you get your body in front of the ball. If she doesn't there, that's a high hop that goes around her, and that's a base knock. Really well fielded by Van Dyken. That one bounces in. 1-1 now. Mirabella, since coming into the ball game, only has one run against on her resume. Again, the difference in the game is an explosive third inning for Loyola. Upstairs, ball two. Wind up and the delivery. Running bunt attempt. Pulled back in time outside. 3-1. Brooke Wilson at the plate. Reached on an error. Flew out and struck out. Not a whole lot doing for her today. Takes that one for a called strike. Full count. Mirabella working with an empty pallet, nobody on base. One out. Here's the delivery. Swung on and fouled over toward the concourse area. Off one of the brick structures over there. Long at bat. Wilson digging back in. Another full count pitch on the way. The delivery. Swung on, fouled, same location. And Sam, this is one of those situations you get in. You don't have a pitch to waste. You've got to throw strikes, but you're trying to throw it in a place where Wilson can't hit it, and that's a difficult jam to be in.
This is a tug-of-war match in which neither side is really winning.
Another foul ball. I'll actually give the edge here to Brooke Wilson. If she's going to keep fouling pitch after pitch off, it's going to become a little bit tougher for Courtney Mirabella to find that strike zone in a place where the batter's not going to be able to hit it. Fourth straight payoff pitch here. The delivery swung on, and that is right on top of second base. Safe is Wilson. You couldn't have thrown it any better out there. That's a bloop single in the infield, and that missed bouncing right off the top of the base by about 3 inches. Single for Wilson. She'll be out there now for Brooke Wodurski. Dangerous hitter, has a home run in the game already. And that is a rocket over the head of Compton all the way out into center. Prickett fields it. And moving all the way around to third base is Wilson. Runners on the corners with one out. And now Mirabella in a dicey situation.
Yeah, now if you're Mirabella, you don't want to put anything in the outfield. Anything in the outfield is going to score a run with one out here, sac fly or not.
Well, the sack fly could come courtesy of Bree Pasquale here. Pasquale today was hit by a pitch, has a single and grounded into a fielder's choice, in which she did end up taking first base. In the cleanup spot, here's the pitch. Upstairs.
Loyola with a double play in the top half of this inning, DeAnder. Or not top. Yeah, top. No.
No, it's definitely last, the top of the inning.
Yeah, last inning to end the bottom half of the fifth. So NC State like to see the same thing here.
Solid pitch there as Mirabella forces Pasquale to take a strike. The inside third of the plate. This is the final game of the evening. NC State wins. They play Northern Illinois tomorrow afternoon. If they lose, they face Delaware State in the morning. High and inside. Ball two. Randy McClam a little slow on that call. Everybody was confused. Did she or didn't she go? No breaking of the wrist there. Especially not parallel to the plate, so still a ball. That one's nearly identical location inside, but going to be called a strike. Inside portion of the plate, is that caught the front corner of the strike zone?
And speaking of consistency of the umpires, Drew, let's not forget to turn our clocks back an hour tonight.
Exactly. Daylight savings time does begin, so make sure you get your times correct or else you'll be showing up to the ball game three innings in. Don't want that to happen.
We want you to be on time.
No, we want you to get all of your money's worth. Admission is free, though. Two-two count now. That one bounces into home. Full count here. Katie Kasubke on deck. Sort of a pick-your-poison. Nearly identical resumes with Pasquale. The only advantage to a walk here is that there's a force at every base. Mirabella comes set, delivers, swing and a miss, strike three! Courtney Mirabella with another K to her resume. And now it's going to fall on Katie Kasubke with runners on the corners and two outs. Kasubke with a single in the third inning, struck out and grounded out. Low ball one. Well, if you like tense situations, this has been the game for you. State has constantly gotten themselves in a jam, and sometimes Courtney Mirabella has done her best Harry Houdini to magically get out of them. This one is popped back up into the screen. Just over the screen, actually. Into the stands. And 20 seconds of seeing an NCAA game softball and holding it in your hands before turning it back to the press box. 1-1, two outs. Swung on, this is popped. Compton has it and is under it. And once again, another pair of runners stranded by the Loyola Ramblers. NC State down to six offensive outs remaining. They are going to need to use the entirety of them. They're down three. Bottom of the sixth coming up. You're watching NC State Softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports.
Back to Raleigh. Crisp, clear evening in the city of Oaks.
Leading off for the Wolfpack will be Maggie Hawkins. Hannah Summer, who's played hero for NC State with a two-run shot in the bottom of the fourth inning, will be on deck. Jeff Scamore, who oddly enough has grounded out to the shortstop twice. She'll be in the hole. State does have a guarantee to get back around to Lana Van Dyken, but right now that's it. They need to really extend this batting order, and right here is the inning that you'd hope to do it, especially with these first two hitters coming up in Hawkins and Summer. Hawkins digging in, having flown out and singled her third plate appearance of the night. Watches that one float in there low for a ball. During their last series of batters, Meredith Burrows hit a sharp line drive down the third base line, caught by Jamie O'Brien. This one to Adursky, who leaps up and makes the play. She was already playing deep at the shortstop position, and Hawkins couldn't quite get it over her. Nice play.
Good play by Wadurski, not losing her head too much, just kind of coasting back there, focusing on catching the ball, whether she needed to jump or not.
Hannah Summer had a home run in the fourth. I would love to have another one here. Here's the pitch. That floats in there for a strike off speed.
And Joe, it does look like to me that both the teams NC State has played today have been willing to play around with the off-speed pitch a little bit more than NC State has.
Respect the gas here. Nope, that one's going to go right back up the middle. Fielded by Wadurski. She couldn't get it. That'll be a base knock. That's a tough play to make for Wadurski. She came in and touched the ball initially right behind second base and got crossed up in herself and a bouncing ball. And Hannah Summer is on first base, and I can almost guarantee you that Sean Reichick's roster change is going to be a pinch runner, and it is. Natalie Jones, the Stedman, North Carolina native, will come out and take to first base. A little bit more speed out there on the base paths as the freshman Jessica Moore will keep her batter spot right now. On deck, Alyssa Compton. Moore really wants to keep this one out of the middle of the infield unless it's going to go right back up the pipe. So long as this is not a double play ball, that does guarantee Tyler Ross another at bat, which is really what you're looking at. Production from the bottom of the lineup is something State enjoyed in yesterday's contests, including against the same Loyola Ramblers team, but not so much today. A strike one comes into Jessica Moore.
And if you're NC State, I mean, just as you mentioned, they had it yesterday, production at the bottom half of the lineup, and that's something that's really been lacking today, and I think that can speak volumes to why that 7-3 loss and now they're down 5-2 in this second game. When your second half of your lineup can't produce, that doesn't leave anyone on when the top half of your lineup comes up to bat, so it's hard to get runs home when there's no one on base.
Moore's fouls one into the heel of her cleat. 1-2 pitchers count here for Kylie Jones. As I look out there on the scoreboard, too, State has 7 hits today and has had some trouble bringing runners home. Loyola with 9 and 5 runs. Moore, grounder, right back up to second base. Lead runner is going to advance, but Moore is going to be thrown out at first. So a runner in scoring position with 2 outs now for the sophomore, Alyssa Compton. And Compton is going to retreat back into the dugout here. Macaulay Prickett in the on-deck circle, but she's not going to be the one to come to the plate, I can guarantee you that. My choice here would be Hannah Yeager. And it's going to instead be Brittany Nimmo, who has played hero before, had a double yesterday. Nimmo, the pitcher, who started this ball game, is going to come in and bat, or will she? Nope, she's back to the dugout. And instead, maybe now we have the correct batter coming out. Sean Reichick giving instruction. And well, I'd love to tell you who the batter is, but I haven't seen the number yet. All we know is a pinch hitter coming up for NC State. And it is, well, after all of that fiasco, it's all for naught, it's all for show, it's one big charade as Alyssa Compton is going to come back up and bat for herself. Well, you talk about manufacturing your own break and being able to get some discussion, that was nothing more than an elaborate scene change, and now Alyssa Compton's going to come up here and bat for herself. She'll see ball one. Sam, I don't think I've quite seen that. That was very interesting.
I'm not really sure what happened either, Drew. I don't know.
Another one outside. Sort of like when you have two cars in the car commercials. Option one, option two, option one. Let's go with option one. Or I should say option 21. Compton now, 2-0 in her favor. Bounces this one. She's going to have to get some speed to get out of first base. Throw in time by a step. Loyola survives, and NC State is going to have to try to come back in the bottom of the seventh. But first, the Ramblers going to try to add to the three-run lead. Seventh inning of the barn burner in Raleigh. You're watching NC State softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television. Seventh inning time in Raleigh, Curtis and Jaclyn Dale Softball Stadium, the site of the Doubletree RDU Challenge. I'm Drew Blevins alongside Sam LaFell. Sam, it's been an interesting ball game. NC State really trying to eschew the memory of a third inning that saw four runs against. And this will be 6, 7, 8 hole hitters coming up, led by Katie La Civita.
If you're NC State, if you're an NC State fan, it kind of has been a nail biter. You know, a couple runs, that ball's right back towards us, landed just outside the press box, actually. But for an NC State fan, it has been a nail biter. You know, you have seven hits, you get runners on. You haven't been not producing, you just haven't been converting on those opportunities.
0-1 to La Civita, who's worked essentially as an extra leadoff hitter. She's led off three times in this game, the second inning, the fifth inning, and the seventh inning, where she's been the first batter up. Squares herself around with an 0-2 count. Mirabella eyes the target, fires, swung on, over the head of the shortstop, Van Dyken. Leadoff single for La Civita. Nice piece of hitting, too.
That was a nice way to pull that out on the left field, just over the head of Van Dyken.
Well, Mirabella has a leadoff runner on, and Jeff Talca is over having a discussion.
It's like that'll be a pitch runner.
And that's exactly who it's going to be. Looks like... Well, I initially was going to say it's Madison Hope.
Jordan Cordell.
Pardon me, it's Jordan Cordell. It's very difficult to read the numbers downstairs. It's sort of that maroon color on a charcoal gray, dark on dark. For a fashion statement, very nice uniforms from Loyola. From the practical perspective of being able to read the numbers from up here in the press box, eh, maybe not so much. Nonetheless, Jordan Cordell will be the pinch runner on first. The batter is Hannah Jenkins. She fouls one into the screen.
Not sure softball is as much about the fashion statement.
Oh, it's all about the fashion statement. Wind up in the pitch. That one batted down. I mean, still standing out to me is the fact Virginia Tech wore their Hokie orange in every facet they possibly could when they come here. Softball, unlike baseball, you're not restricted to home white and road gray. You can really start to work a lot of different color combinations. And you can really make a fashion statement out there. This one is a bullet all the way out to the wall. Could be a double. Jenkins wheeling around. Stop signal at third base. Cordell will not come around to score, but two in scoring position. Loyola can really burst this thing open here in the top of the seventh. My, oh, my. That was a rocket.
I got to the wall pretty quick.
That'll bring up Alyssa Minucci. Second baseman, singled back in the first inning, nothing doing since. Fly out and a strikeout. Mirabella in a jam, goes inside. Ball one.
Playing some chin music, trying to get her off the plate a little bit. I'd like to see Mirabella go for the outside corner of that plate now.
Rock back the delivery, oh. Inside again.
Right back to the same spot.
Mirabella is going to be the pitcher going forward. Not a whole lot of help left in the bullpen. Certainly the only listed pitcher left. Another one inside. Check on the appeal. That is going to be a strike. 2-1 count. Still free base open down at first. That one inside, pulled back. That one's going back toward the traffic signals directly behind the press box. Count even at two.
Mirabella has worked all four pitches. It's bat inside. So I'd like to see what she does on this one.
Working outside, possibly. Nope, going to go back to the inner portion of the plate and misses at a full count now. Playing with fire, Jamie O'Brien, who had a single her last at bat, coming up. Behind her is the top of the order, Erica Nagel. Here's the pitch. Swung on and foul. Good contact. Just yanked a little too much down the third base line. You know, yeah. you'd look at this from a perspective of saying, well, Drew, it's a three-run game. Yeah, it is a three-run game, but State has been known to have big explosive innings, and Loyola is in the midst of trying to quench any hope. That's right back up the middle. Mirabella looks off the runner at third, fires to first for the force out there, one out in the inning.
Great job, Mirabella, there, not to have more tunnel vision trying to get that out at first, but she looks down the runner at third and then goes over to first.
Jamie O'Brien, third baseman, one strikeout, one ground out, one single, and was caught stealing. First pitch to her, reached out, fouled back. Looked to me like she was late on the decision to swing there. Might should have laid off. Seeing if Randy McLam would have been kind to her. Digging back in, 0-1, one out. Runners on second and third. Here's the delivery. High and away for ball one.
Just tiptoeing around this inning, Courtney Mirabella is. She'd love to get out of this unscathed, not giving up any runs.
Well, she's on thin ice, that's for certain. Any hit that's in toward the middle infield, you'd expect a run to score. That one's going to be fouled back onto the concourse. 1-2 now. This is where you want it, because now you have a couple of pitches to play with, and with a 9-hole hitter, maybe a little overzealous to swing. Serica Nagel coming up next, that could be the more difficult one to negotiate. Certainly O'Brien, love to make a difference. Here's the pitch. That one's high. Count even, deuces aside.
Missed high and in. I'd love for her to miss low and away, if she's going to miss anywhere.
Well, she'd love to send one just on the outside portion of the plate here. That's, nope, high and in. Full count. Exact same thing that happened to Minucci, and Mirabella forced her into a ground out back up the middle. Maybe, can O'Brien rewrite the script?
Maybe get him defending up high and then send something down low and not ready for it.
Nope. Reaching slapped at ball, fouled. State's next ball game will either be at 10:15 tomorrow morning against Delaware State or 12:30 in the afternoon against Northern Illinois. That depends on the result of this ball game. If State wins, they'll play the Huskies again. Right back up to the shortstop. Van Dyken can't make the play. Out of the outfield. One will score. Play at the plate. Cut off. Standing double for Jamie O'Brien, and two more come across to score. And Sam, that is a dagger.
That is just a momentum killer for this Wolfpack team, if they had any before this. Two runs in for Loyola. That's a 7-2 lead now. NC State's going to need a very big inning in the bottom of the seventh to come back from this.
Their last five-run inning came in the fifth against Virginia Tech 6 days ago. That one's going to get through, and another base knock.
Well, I guess let's not forget that this inning is not over yet. There's only one out. Now there's runners on the corner for Loyola, so they have a chance to knock on some more.
Brooke Wilson comes back to the plate here. Sean Rychik is out to have a discussion with Courtney Mirabella. And I just can't imagine what's going on in his head right now. Certainly expecting to be able to beat Loyola, not necessarily in another run rule game, but finds himself down 7-2. He's given up 12 knocks, two defensive errors committed. By the way, the Jamie O'Brien batted ball was credited as an error against Lana Van Dyken, so that is not a base hit. But a run does score off of it, a couple of them actually. Score now 7-2, 12 hits for Loyola in this ballgame, and only one defensive error. NC State 7 knocks, 2 runs scored, 2 defensive errors. And in comes Brooke Wilson. Well, this is a little bit of retribution if Loyola can finish this one off for the run rule loss to the Pack yesterday, and Delaware State will be looking for nothing less in their turn to face off against the Wolfpack tomorrow morning should Delaware have the fortune to face the Pack. Mirabella looks off the runner at third, throws to first, and another out. And here is Brooke Widerski. And in your wildest dream, Sam, did you think that Widerski was going to come back around in the seventh? She's 6 men deep from the start of the batting order, but she's going to be here.
I expected Loyola to go through, maybe get a run or two on, not on the board, but just on base somewhere, and then go down without much noise because they're already up by 3 runs.
Don't believe I got a chance to mention it, but Molly Hutchison did re-enter the ballgame and is the catcher now instead of Cheyenne Balzer. That one's inside. That one hit the knob of the bat, foul.
She didn't try to act like it hit her arm, so no Golden Globe over here. Emmy, whatever you would call that award.
I believe that would be an Oscar.
Oscar, that's what those are called.
Nope, that she knew it as soon as she pulled her hands back right off the bottom of the bat. Two and one. Mirabella rocks and fires. Good pitch. Called strike. 2-2 count as Widerski will dig back in. Mirabella gets the signal off her wristband. Comes center. Fires. Misses up. Third full count of the inning.
It's just a long inning for Courtney Mirabella.
Well, there is a free base at first. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three.
She won't need it.
Widerski certainly swung at ball four there on a high inside pitch, but NC State is going to have to get the rally caps going. Down 5, bottom of the 7th, coming up next on Wolfpack Sports Television and GoPack.com. Raleigh, NC State trails the Loyola Ramblers 7-2. It's been a very good day for Loyola. Macaulay Prickett, the 9-hole hitter, will end things off. Lana Van Dyken on deck. Tyler Ross in the hole. They're the iron 3 for now. Prickett has a single in the game. That's about it. Slaps this one back up the middle. Diving play. Widerski can't make it. Prickett is on base. Well, how do you like that?
One pitch, one runner on.
That's a tough play for Widerski to make. She's committed an error earlier. We'll see what the scores are going to say about this one.
That'll be a base hit.
I agree. Lana Van Dyken back at the top of the order. Van Dyken, a couple of base knocks today, most recently in the 5th. Kylie Jones sets fires. Van Dyken, that is roped out to center. Nice catch made by Wilson. Had to track a little bit of a ways to get over there. First out with Prickett, representing some speed on first base, and here comes Tyler Ross.
Only 2 pitches thrown in the inning and about to see your 3rd different batter. Looks like NC State might need to sit on a few pitches this at bat.
Well, I don't know. I mean, a lot of first pitch strikes, and they're good pitches. Go ahead and stroke them. Really not a lot of strategy right now. You're just trying to get base runners on. Ross watches that one in, low and away for ball one. Molly Hutchison is on deck. One out in the inning and a 1-0 count here to Tyler Ross. That's a good stroke, just foul. Trying to do the double opposite way down the line. Just can't straighten it up enough. Not the best game for Ross. Popped out to second base and has struck out twice in a row. So to say she's due is a perfectly legitimate statement. 1-1. Swing and a miss. This has not been her game.
Her eyes have been bigger than her stomach today.
1-2 pitch. One to waste for Jones should she choose. She will. Outside looking to get Ross to chase one she had no hope of hitting. Even count 2-2. Prickett still on first. 2-2 delivery. Slow balled. Tyler Ross got the benefit of the doubt there. That one looked good. Full count. Maybe low. Full count pitch. Here you go. Ross fouls it off. Hanging in there. Got to give her credit.
Good job to stay alive after the questionable ball three.
Kylie Jones has given up 8 hits. Very good about getting ground ball and fly ball outs. Full count pitch. Outside. Ross down to first base. And up comes Molly Hutchison now. Couple of options to work with. Now you can start talking strategy. Although I'm sure Sean Reichick's preferred strategy right here would be Molly Hutchison, send it somewhere over the black wall out in the outfield. So long as it's between the foul poles, that is.
Bust a late pole, make it happy.
Big at bat for Hutchison. First pitch to her. Called strike on the outside portion of the plate. Nice pitch.
Nice placement there by Kylie Jones.
Meredith Burrows on deck. She's got Hawkins behind her. Wind up and the delivery. Slow ball misses up. When you're going to send those off-speed pitches, you really cannot afford to leave them in that location. Fortunately, it was just too far outside to merit a swing. You don't want to make that mistake to Molly Hutchison. And that one's low.
If that ball had come in further inside than it was, Hutchison would have been all over that.
Bree Pasquale coming in and having a quick word with Jones, and I mean a quick word. She took a few steps in and gave a word of encouragement. 2-1 delivery. Right back up the middle, off the glove. Everybody's going to be safe. Bases loaded. That's a hard hit ball off the heel of the glove of the pitcher, Jones. And now it's infield meeting time as the bases are loaded for Maggie Hawkins. Well, Meredith Burrows with a swing of the bat can get this to a one-run game. She can't tie it, but she can turn this back over to Maggie Hawkins and Hannah Summer, who are both very capable hitters. Loyola found themselves in a very similar position a couple of times in this tournament in games where they had a lead or didn't have the lead, and were able to put runners on and make it a scary bottom of the seventh inning. They did it to Northern Illinois. Well, here comes Meredith Burrows. Sophomore first baseman digging in. No batting gloves, just bare hands and a bat grip.
No hits in the game, so I would say she's due.
That's outside. Last play was scored a base hit. Wind up of the pitch at 1-0. Misses outside. 2-0, and I'm not so sure if I'm Burrows. I wouldn't just sit on this one and take it.
I think you're right.
She's not going to throw you a strike. Base is loaded here. There it is outside. Oh, boy.
You do not want to walk in a run right now if you're Kylie Jones.
No, you don't, especially with Maggie Hawkins and Hannah Summer coming up next. Wind up in the 3-0. There's a called strike.
Good decision.
Big pitch, and Burrow should have the green light here. but it's going to have to be something good. Here it is. Burrows offers down the line. Throw home. There's the force out. That ball just stayed fair, almost scooted foul. Prickett thrown out. The bases will be loaded for Maggie Hawkins with two outs. Fresh count for Hawkins in the five hole. First pitch to her. Offers at it. That's going to be a scoring run single. And it's only going to score one run. Hutchison inching off of third. Sort of that collective, no, 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 don't do that. Run scores on the play. RBI single for Maggie Hawkins, and Hannah Summer
represents the tying run.
And she's had a home run today against this very same pitcher.
And a home run yesterday.
Well, for Hannah Summer, the junior, young lady dig in, perhaps no bigger at bat.
And now batting, number 44, Hannah Summer.
She's been announced over the PA system. Thus commence the battle. Fresh count, bases chalked full, down four, two outs. And after all of that mounting pressure and the scenario laid out, she's going to step out or regather her thoughts and come back into the box.
She's thinking about where she wants to hit the home run.
Kylie Jones eyes the target, rocks back, fires. And that one is outside. State fortunate to be in this position after giving up two runs in the top of this inning. Here's the pitch. That one also outside.
Also notable, there are two outs, so got to be careful.
On deck is Jessica Moore. Should she be needed, she's out there taking the warm-up swings. 2-0 pitch. Summer offers at it, fouls it down the third base line. 2-1. You would imagine that if Summer does reach base here, they're going to pull her out of the ball game just to have some more speed out there on the base paths. 2-1 count, two outs. Big pitch coming. Wind-up delivery. Summer crushes it, but it's right to left fielder. The ball game is over. Jenkins with the over-the-shoulder reaching backhand catch. Loyola survives a seventh inning scare. And they've defeated the NC State Wolfpack 7-3. We will next be on the air tomorrow at around 10:15 in the morning as NC State will play in the third place game against the Delaware State Hornets, a team that they defeated 12-0 last night. It's a big win for Loyola as they will take on Northern Illinois for the third time in the weekend. And that should be a barn burner of a softball game. We hope you'll join us tomorrow morning. Again, the final score here from Raleigh, Loyola 7, NC State 3. Signing off for Sam LaFell and the rest of our crew, I'm Drew Blevins. Thanks for watching NC State Softball on GoPack.com and Wolfpack Sports Television, bringing you into the pack. We hope you have a lovely Saturday night and hope...